name is Leila, L-E-I-L-A, and they used to call me L.A. when I was young. I was made in L.A., actually. My mother's from Mexico. My father's from New York, but I was born in L.A., so I gotta love L.A. What part of L.A. do I love the best? I don't know. Sometimes I like the beach, sometimes I like the hood, sometimes I like Malibu, too. The thing about New York and L.A. is that the mediums that exist in the two cities, the film industry, all the new media, everything has been centered around the actual exploitation of artists in these two cities. And so you get to experience the entire world living in an area that everybody comes to cultivate and develop their art. So, you know, I've been running away from L.A. my whole life, but I always end up back here. I always feel the need to come and reconnect because I know if I do something in L.A., the whole world is going to see it. L.A. is just a deep city because people, it's the communication center of the world, and people come from everywhere to see and be in L.A. A girl here in L.A., in this city, I really found my voice through the arts, through the musicians that, you know, filled these streets when I was a kid. And through the arts, it was the one place that all of us, didn't matter where we came from, what our backgrounds were, we all came together with art. Wanted to be able to motivate kids to succeed in spite of whatever their history or her stories or past were, and not be dictated by their pain or their struggle, but by their promise and the use of their voices. So I've just spent, you know, now I used to say 10 or 15, now it's 30 plus years cultivating art in the lives of young people and in my own life. Even more clear how accountable I need to be to kids all over the world that look to us, that are looking for guidance through their leaders. And who are their leaders? I love, you know, a lot of people who make a commitment to politics, but I believe our leadership really comes from our artists' voices. And so I have wanted to help develop artists' voices that can be our politicians, that can be our educators, that can be the primary sources of growth and healing and change, so that we actually help to create a society where it's not about your isms anymore, and you can be old or young, we don't throw away our elders, you can be gay or straight. We have finally come to a place where we all embrace one another, and so I just love being in LA and being part of a community of artists that are absolutely committed to utilizing their art to make these changes happen, and that it will only take one generation now, with the way we're moving and critical mass and the consciousness that's coming in, to see an entire shift in the spirit of people, where we look in the mirror instead of looking outside and say, how can I be an example of embracing all of my family and my loved ones, and that my loved ones are not defined by my genealogy or by birth, but that we are at a place now where we realize that we are human family.